So you guys know I like Bollywood, and one thing Bollywood loves to do is to remake films from other countries, often illegally. The other day I was looking into one such film, the 2017 Salman Khan vehicle Tube Light. I saw that it was based on an American film by the name of Little Boy.
Dreamers, dreamers.
And I thought, huh, that looks weird. Little Boy is a film from 2015 that I had never heard of in my life. It is essentially a period Christian war film. And interestingly, unlike most modern faith-based films, which are typically rooted in evangelical Christianity, this film is actually rooted in Catholicism. And listen, I have no problem with Christianity or Catholicism. However, I do kind of have a problem with faith-based films. I do think there's a difference between faith-based films and films that happen to have Christian elements or religious themes. I don't mind a film that operates on the assumption that God exists. I feel like a lot of films do. But I do mind films whose sole purpose and message is to either proselytize or make all non-Christians look like horrible people, a la pure flicks. This isn't the worst Christian film. I appreciate that it actually sends a message about faith and the development of faith, rather than just being about this blind, unquestionable worship that you often see in faith-based films. But it really is just a bad movie otherwise, and I'm not the only one who thinks so. Little Boy was written and directed by a Mexican filmmaker, Alejandro Gomez Monteverde. Monteverde has so far directed only two feature films, Little Boy and a film called Bella, that also got bad reviews and appears to have an anti-abortion message. So I kind of assume that this director is, you know, a conservative Catholic. Anyways, having now watched Little Boy, I can tell you that it indeed is a superficial, melodramatic, trite, somewhat offensive film, and it's also pretty funny, so I would like to share it with you today. The film opens with some old-timey folksy narration playing over some old-timey folksy footage of the town of O'Hare, California, an idyllic portrait of good old-fashioned white people Americana.
Back then, it was nothing more than a sleepy fishing village with a hill at the end of Main Street.
We immediately meet this tiny little nerd. Everyone hates him because he's tiny and little.
Stop causing trouble, you midget.
Nobody in that town liked me much.
No, seriously, that's the premise of the movie. He's a boy. And he's little. The kid is very close with his father, and I'm sorry, but did anyone have this good of a relationship with their father in the 40s? Like, dads are emotionally unavailable now. I can't even imagine trying to communicate with mine during World War II. Little Boy and his dad are really into this superhero named Ben Eagle. It's like the foundation of their wonderful, wholesome relationship. The kid has an older brother named London, played by none other than Justin from Wizards of Waverly Place. You thought I was gonna say 13 Reasons Why. No, different Justin. I think I'm just gonna call him Justin because that is the only character I will ever see him as. The narrator's talking about the war, and there's this brief shot of a man holding a newspaper with Hitler on it over his face, which seems like it's supposed to be significant, but I honestly don't understand what it's trying to say. Justin is trying to enlist in the army but gets a 4F because he has flat feet. Like a lot of white men, Justin blindly worships the US military, so he's really upset about this. Meanwhile, Little Boy's dad is like really obsessed with cowboy boots. It's a pretty big part of his character, but I can't really clown him for that. For some reason, because Justin can't join the army, the dad has to join instead? Mulan style? Is that how that works? Throughout the whole movie, I couldn't tell if this child actor was good at acting or if he was just really, really cute.
Why can't we stay together?
Partner, I have to go.
I don't want you to go.
He is incredibly cute. Wait, Kevin James is in this movie? Kevin James plays the town doctor, and at the beginning of the scene, he says this like woke thing.
I'm not a midget, right?
We shouldn't use that word. Midget is a mean word for people with dwarfism.
Which is weird both because it's the 40s and because the film quickly shows us that his character is kind of a bad guy, so like why would he make such an effort to be politically correct? It's pretty obvious that Kevin James is having some impure thoughts about Little Boy's mom. We get a title drop and it's pretty weird.
But for now, Pepper, let's just say you're a little boy.
Why is it shot like that? Why does Kevin James say it like that? But anyways, Little Boy now has the cruel nickname of Little Boy. By the way, we eventually find out that his real name is Pepper? So you're telling me, you mean to tell me that these two named their kids London and Pepper? What is wrong with you people? There's this guy who works in the family's auto shop who, for lack of a better description, is basically Lenny from Of Mice and Men.
He said you were, you want to know what he called you?
No, I don't.
If you haven't noticed, this film isn't terribly subtle. So Little Boy buys his dad the precious cowboy boots that he's had his eye on because his dad is set to come home soon. But of course, the day the dad was supposed to return from his service, the family is told that he's been taken as a prisoner of war, you know the drill. They show us this happening in this hilarious sequence that intercuts the dad being captured in battle with Little Boy being bullied and thrown in a dumpster. I don't really know what this is supposed to symbolize. Is bullies throwing kids into dumpsters like the war at home? Also, you mean to tell me that generic bully characters knew the word traumatized in 1942?
We can't call him midget. You could traumatize him.
Unlikely. Why are there two whole dead crabs in this dumpster? So Little Boy and his family are very sad about the dad being gone, and Justin starts to descend into alcoholism. Little Boy is obsessed with that superhero, magician, action serial kind of character called Ben Eagle from before. I guess he's like a local talent because he just shows up at the movie theater one day. He invites Little Boy on stage to do a magic trick with him, which doesn't work for an awkward amount of time. Anyways, I think it restores Little Boy's faith in himself or whatever. There's a scene of the family in church, and you start to get this creeping sense of dread. And you start to ask yourself, is this a Christian movie? Sadly, yes. Little Boy is very inspired by the sermon about the mustard seed. You know, that mustard seed thing in the Bible.
If we have faith the size of a mustard seed, we can move a mountain.
I'm not too caught up on my Bible study, but you know the one. Not to be nitpicky, but have the filmmakers ever seen a mustard seed? Aren't mustard seeds way smaller than that? That looks more like a peppercorn. Hashtag know your spices, sheeple. Little Boy is at the store when he suddenly runs into a Japanese man. And then the movie takes a turn.
There's a Jap at Dillard's.
Store doesn't serve Japs.
Little Boy is super racist, and so is the whole town. This movie has a don't be racist towards Japanese people message, but it also really glosses over the whole idea of Japanese internment camps, which, I don't know. Little Boy and his brother are so racist that they go and vandalize the Japanese man's house. His brother tries to set it on fire, which leads to them getting caught, and Justin goes to jail. Little Boy has to go reflect on his sins in church or whatever, and the priest tries to get him to replicate the magician's trick from before. Again, it goes on for way too long. Little Boy is trying to understand faith. He wants bigger faith, so the priest presents him with this ancient list of things that he can do to increase his faith, I guess. I don't know enough about Catholicism to know if this is a real thing. All my Catholics out there, comment down below and let me know. The priest adds to the list and tells the little boy he has to befriend the Japanese man.
Befriend Hashimoto? Are you crazy?
So Little Boy starts hanging out with the Japanese man, Hashimoto, and everyone starts bullying him more because they all hate Japanese people. Hashimoto helps little boy complete the other items on the list. They visit the sick by visiting someone at the hospital. Apparently Lenny from Of Mice and Men sleeps at the shop, so they house the homeless by offering him their spare room. They clothe the naked by having little boy knit something for an expectant mother's baby. Leave it to the Catholic propaganda movie to give this much attention to a character who is a fetus. Kevin James is back, and the movie's making fun of him for being a big fat guy.
Is that, casserole I smell?
Isn't that funny that he's a big fat guy? Yeah. In that same vein, it's also interesting that the big mean bully character in the movie is a fat kid. Coincidence, I'm sure. Again, it seems like Kevin James is kind of into the mom, which leads him to bail Justin out of jail. Hashimoto teaches little boy about samurai, because I guess that's the only notable thing about Japan, right? This sequence is complete with in-movie historical reenactments, like we're on the History Channel or something. So I guess that samurai lesson gave little boy the courage to stand up to his bullies.
I'm finishing you this time!
Kurosawa could never. He stands up to his bully by calling him a fat motherless pig and clocking him in the face with his metal lunchbox, which the movie frames as a very triumphant moment, but doesn't seem very in line with this movie's whole anti-hatred Catholic message. Little boy invites Hashimoto over to his house. He hits it off with the mom, but of course this angers Justin because he's still racist. Justin leaves and comes back in with a gun. At this point, I was like, good luck redeeming this one, movie. I don't really believe in corporal punishment, but I was with the mom on this one. The whole town is being racist to Hashimoto when little boy suddenly comes up with the idea that maybe he can bring his dad back with his faith. He's like, Justin, God says you can move a mountain with a mustard seed or something. And Justin's like, fine, then do it. And he tries. And suddenly there's an earthquake. So, functionally, in the movie's logic, little boy has just succeeded in proving the existence of God. So little boy now justifiably believes he has the power of God on his side.
Don't fuck with me! I have the power of God and anime on my side!
And begins trying to will his father to come back. Meanwhile, the whole town is talking about what happened. My favorite character is this guy at the barbershop.
Truth is, that earthquake would have happened whether that boy was there or not.
It's weird because they're kind of framing the racist people in the town as the non-believers. Like, they're the ones saying that all that God stuff is a load of hooey, which I just don't think is incredibly historically accurate. I can't help laughing every time this kid tries to use his powers. It's always, like, edited so awkwardly.
It's a miracle.
Little boy gets a letter from the White House saying that the only way to send our troops back home is to end this war. So presumably he's now trying to bring his dad back by ending the war. Little boy's faith inspires everyone in town, and suddenly, one day, something crazy happens. Little boy is riding his bike through town, and everybody's like, little boy, you did it.
There he is! Little boy's here! You did it!
And he's like, what do you mean? And they show him a newspaper that announces the bombing of Hiroshima and therefore the end of the war. And they're like, little boy, you did it. You did this. Yeah, in the logic of the movie, little boy caused the nuclear bombing of Hiroshima. Good on you, little boy. Good on you. You're a hero. Luckily, the film does kind of address the implications of this, like, little boy seems disturbed by the destruction caused by the bombings, but he only really seems concerned for his dad's safety. He never really expresses any sympathy for, like, the hundreds of thousands of innocent Japanese lives lost. So the racist guys in town, including Justin, trash Hashimoto's house and beat him up, but Justin finally sees the light and saves him, but it lands him back in jail and almost kills Hashimoto. And little boy's family get news that the dad is dead, so little boy's life sucks pretty bad right now. I'm not a professional or anything, but my advice to the director would be to just cut this funeral scene out, or at least the end of it. You don't need this. We know he's sad. This is just so corny and awkward. Now, the movie would probably be better if the dad just died, and Hashimoto kind of became Little Boy's father figure, and the whole ordeal was what strengthened Little Boy's faith. But because this movie is stupid and bad, of course there has to be a miraculous misunderstanding revealing the dad actually is alive. Turns out some other guy in the army took the dad's boots and dog tags before dying, leading to a big old mix-up, classic switcheroo. After finding this out, Justin says again, "You did it, little boy. You did it.
You did it, you little runt. You did it."
Like this was all directly his doing. They go to see the dad in the hospital. He appears to have some amnesia, but then he also seems to pretty much immediately remember everything, so it's fine. The movie ends with this shot of a car headed to O'Hare, which I really don't understand. Is that supposed to be the grown-up narrator? Is it supposed to be symbolic for some kind of abstract idea of new people coming to the town as it changes over time? I have no idea. So what is the point of this movie? I get the faith thing, and I think that's somewhat good. I mean, like I said, the point of most faith-based movies you see is either to convince you to be Christian, or to convince people who are already Christian that they are the greatest people on earth and can do no wrong. So I appreciate a Christian film that actually attempts to say something, and that actually promotes, like, kindness and helping the less fortunate as aspects of Christianity. That being said, I think all of that is kind of overshadowed by everything else. This movie wants to give the illusion of having an anti-racist message by showing one individual overcoming their hatred and fear of one individual of a different race, while also centering the story around the white characters, glossing over some serious human rights atrocities committed against Japanese people during World War II, and essentially justifying the bombing of Hiroshima by creating a fictional child whose fictional father was maybe indirectly saved by said bombing. It kind of reminds me of those racist people who say, "I can't be racist, I have a black friend." Sure, you may have befriended an individual of a different race, but you still directly benefit from and contribute to the systems of society that perpetuate racism. It's not that it's particularly surprising or uncommon for a film to glorify the US military, right? That is still the dominant discourse in this country, that military good, nuclear weapons good, when we're the ones using them. Hundreds of thousands of civilian deaths justified if for the perceived greater good. I mean, those people are foreign. We don't have to care about them. America first. Something worse would have happened if we didn't ruthlessly obliterate all those innocent people. It's just, it's possible to puff up the US military a little bit and have just a little nuance about an event like this, right? I mean, the whole thing is about a boy befriending a Japanese man, and we don't even hear anything about how that Japanese character feels about the bombings. We see little boy have a nightmare about the bomb, but the only Japanese character in the entire story doesn't even get to have feelings about the situation. Hashimoto is in the film to be the patient, kind, palatable minority that completes the white protagonist's character arc. The filmmakers don't actually care about Japanese people. If they did, they would have created a character with agency and motivations and feelings. You know, like a person. But enough about all that. I know what all of you are thinking, and by all of you, I mean none of you. Yes, this film was remade in Bollywood. It's called Tube Light. Rather than World War II, it's set in the Sino-Indian War of 1962, and they substitute the American to Japanese prejudice for Indian to Chinese prejudice. Hilariously, they replace the little boy character with a grown man character, like a 50-year-old man, Salman Khan. And they replace the fatherly Japanese man character with a young, hot Chinese lady character because this is Bollywood we're talking about. I haven't seen this movie. Maybe I could cover it in the future, compare it to this masterpiece. When it comes to Little Boy, I have to agree with YouTube commenter Plant DeFantasy. Is it just me? Or this boy looks like Chloe Moretz? Anyways, I think I'm gonna go commit war crimes.